So now we finally get into the Bosch dog family. In dog family, first the important thing is that we build upon the concept based on the heart, that 1 minus z, in the effect of 1 minus z inverse, this comes in picture. This is the first point. We try to use maximum number of the maximum number of 1 minus z inverse in high pass side. This is first condition. The second thing which we use in the this Dabhaus family is the concept that the conjugate pair. So what does conjugate mean? That if h0 of z is something like a0, a1, a2, then the conjugate pair which will get associated with it, which is g0 of z, will be nothing but equal to a2, a1, a0. Or in other words, h0 of z inverse times z raised to the power minus b. Let me explain how. So now how can I represent this? The z transpose this. Okay. So by the previous lecture we understood that a of z has to be some constant, or in other words some linear phase system, and this b of z has to be equal to 0. This has to be equal to 0. Or in other words, g1 upon g0 has to be minus of, this minus is very important, times this h0 upon h1. This minus is important. So now, if let us take this k of z equal, or if I equate both of them, this numerator and denominator equally, which is a very intuitive way of thinking, then let this k of z be equal to 1. So just see, if I find this g0 of z in terms of h0 of z, for example, what we say, if I say that g0 of z is equal to h0 of z inverse or something like that, if this is determined, then this g1 is determined, all the parameters are determined. So we just by this stuff, so are you trying to get, this is determined, this is determined, if these both are determined, then automatically the other two are determined. So we just need one equation to determine everything, and that is the relation between g0 and h0 or any stuff. So now let us try to look upon how we are trying to what I am trying to explain. And this is the standard equation. Now if I take this g0 of z equal to some delay times h0 z inverse, just tell me what how this stuff will. And if I take this kind of an equation and substitute in this b of z, I will get is h0 of minus z, this stuff will become equal to 0. Just see, this is an exercise. that put this equation into this, because just see, g0 is something, let me write this as minus e. Just let me try to prove this for you. h0 minus z, h0 of z inverse, let me write it with green, g0, okay? Right. Plus, now what will be the h1 equal to g0, and what is g0 of this stuff? So z raised to the power minus z raised to the power minus what we call d h0 of z inverse at minus z. So this will be minus z inverse, and this minus introduced here will lead to minus 1 to the power d times g1 of, and now what is g1? It's equal to h0 of minus z. So if you just see this equation, then this part, this minus z inverse, this h0 of minus z inverse, and this part has to be equal to 0. And just see, this will get equal to 0. Because this part and this part is same. This part and this part is also same. Just a factor of minus will come, and this will make it 0. So there's no problem in this way of thinking. And similarly, if we see for the other part, we have to have this equal to constant. For this, what we will do is that we will try to look upon how this will be equal to constant. First of all, if this has to be this constant, then this h0 z, g0 of z, how it will work, let's see. h0 of z, g0 of, let me write g0 as h0 z inverse times z raised to the power minus d. Now let us try to see how this has to be equal to some delta or some constant. This is our, let me write this as some, what we tell, c of z. Okay. Now c of z has to be equal to constant. To make this is equal to constant, we do some amount of time analysis. Okay, so now we will study what we call time interpretation. Now remember that we took g0 of z, we tried to decide some g0 z as equal to z raised to the power minus delay times h of z inverse. Now what is the logic behind this? Let me try to clear. Let me take this h of z for some sequence equal to a plus bz inverse plus cz raised to the power minus 2. In time, in this h of n, how will it look? It will look something like this. A, b, and c. See, something like this. Now, if I try to take its conjugate, or if I take conjugate of it, or in other words, let me try to take h of z inverse. What will be h of z inverse? Just see, a plus bz plus a plus bz plus cz square. But how is this sequence? This sequence in time will look something like this. a b c. So if you know the condition for causality, the condition for causality is that h of n should be greater only, should be non-zero only if for this greater than zero, or in other words, h of n must be zero for n less than zero. This is the condition for causality. You know this point. So is h of z inverse a causal system? No, definitely not. It is not causal. So to make it causal, what we do is that we multiply this sequence by some delay. Let me take this delay z risk by minus 2. So the sequence becomes a z raised to the power minus 2 plus b z raised to the minus 1 plus c. So just see how this, if I rearrange the signal, then this is equal to c plus b z inverse plus c plus a. So just compare the coefficients. Here it is a b c, here it is c b a. We call such kind of this, so we call that this in some ways is conjugate of h of z. So z raised to minus 2 h z inverse is conjugate of h z for length is equal to 3, or the highest degree is equal to 2. So in that sense, this is a conjugate. And there is a property, just understand for now. I won't derive it, you can see the derivation of it. But the property states that whenever we multiply, multiplication of hz with its conjugate, any hz with conjugate, makes it a power spectral density, or what we get is something that's power spectral density we get. So if I take this hz and if I multiply it with its conjugate, which I told, it is hz inverse times z raised to power minus delay, some constant delay. So if I do this stuff, then what I will get is something called power spectral density. And if you have studied some amount of signal processing, then you know that power spectral density, the inverse Fourier transform of power spectral density, is equal to the autocorrelation. Correlation. So in that terms, just see that the multiplication. Now you got this picture that the multiplication of this h0, g0 is giving me autocorrelation of this h0, the component with itself. This must be very well understood, autocorrelation. So in some sense, I want to ask one question. My question is, how must be this autocorrelation to get a constant power PSD, power spectral density, or power, how much be the autocorrelation? It must be impulse type. Just think of it, it has to be impulse. So let this autocorrelation, this rxx or whatever we take, rxx of n has to be impulsive, some k times delta of n. It has to be something like this. This is what will form one of the major important concepts for, so let me write it in extension of previous concept, concept number 4, which is very 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 important. This will form the basis of how we will derive the double variables. So now let me now try to take some signal, and also Now let us take, let this HN be equal to something like ABC, and then this GN. Now for autocorrelation, autocorrelation will be something like this. Autocorrelation must be in such a way, let autocorrelation be equal to RxX of n. So this RxX of, first of all, RxX of 0 has to be equal to some k times delta of n. RxX of 1 will be multiplied with 0. RxX of 2. So first let us understand this concept of autocorrelation. Okay. Now if I have this signal h of n, which let me tell it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay, anything. You know, remember I passed it with some signal for decimation 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, impulse 23. So when I pass through it, this signal, this parts got cancelled. So the effective filter which was present was this gets cancelled, this gets cancelled. Or these are placed as 0. You remember this point? So now the effective edge is equal to this 10305. Now if you look at this signal, just tell me about the pattern of autocorrelation. Now how, what is autocorrelation? H of k plus, okay, let me say H of n plus k, summation over all the n's will give me RxX of k. This is the definition of autocorrelation. Now for RxX of 0, it's simply multiplication of it with itself, which will be the maximum. So 1 square plus 3 square plus 5 square. Are you trying to see? 10305 directly multiplied. Then RxX of 1 is that I am shifting this by factor of 1. 1, then this is 0, this is 3, then this is 0, and then this is 5. And I am multiplying this signal, this one singly shifted version by itself, which will lead to all zeros. So this RxX of 1 is equal to 0 always, and therefore what we conclude is that autocorrelation of this particular kind of signal, so RxX of 0 is maximum as always, RxX of 1 is 0, RxX of 2 is something, but RxX of 3 is again 0. So in that sense, all the even parts of autocorrelation are 0. This we can call it as concept number 6. Because this will be very important in trying to understand Hart. So if you have understood this concept, then this becomes this problem of understanding this Rx, why, how we are proceeding with this stuff is very easy. So now if you see the way in which this log2 or the simple Haar wavelet functions, this Haar wavelet functions in a very simple way, the discrete Haar wavelet, okay? That one, this just observe that are they satisfied? That first of all, that the equations which we had considered, that g1 of z is equal to minus of h0 of minus z. First, what is h0 of minus z? 1 minus z inverse and minus of that. So this g1 is equal to minus of 1 minus z inverse. Similarly, this g0 of z is equal to h1 of minus z. This is also satisfied here in this case, this R value. Also, if you see that now, how will the autocorrelation of h0 with itself function? Sorry, this h1, this function, okay? Just simply 1 comma minus 1 or anything, if you take this h0, then definitely it has to be this 1 minus 1. If you try to do this stuff with itself, and try to shift it, then definitely there is no scope for that the signal will be 2 at 0, something at some this other points, and some other stuff that we are not careful about. But the thing is that at this even positions, because the order is in such a way, this 0th position is equal to 2. We don't care about 1 and minus 1. These are don't care conditions. Just understand, very important. These are don't care conditions. Why are they don't care conditions? Because they are all obviously eliminated. Because this x, because of the multiplication with the this decimation process. So what we care is only about even positions. So in this dot 2, obviously because the order of the filter is 2, therefore the this autocorrelation will go up to maximum 2 only. So the length overall will be 3, but this or 2n minus 1 will be the length of the autocorrelation. But the highest point till the positive or negative side will be of length 2n. Now, if you take a higher order of this R wavelet, which is DOC 4, now if you consider DOC 4, you have 0, 1, 2, and 3. In DOC 2, there were 2. Now, we have to have 2. At zero position we don't have to care because it has to be positive only. We have one variable which we have to make zero. This has to be made zero. This making of this point 2 at zero will lead to one equation which we have to solve, or one unknown. Very important. One unknown. This one unknown will lead to a variable, number of variables, a variable which is v1, number of variables will be equal to 1. And now as it is an this has length 4, that means that it has to have some other zeros also. So the number of zeros have to be equal to 2, sorry, number of zeros totally, this 1 minus z inverse pair will have to be of 2, so overall number of zeros have to be 3. Because you saw that number of zeros are equal to n minus 1, where n is the length, or let me tell l minus 1, where l is the length of the filter. So if l is the length of filter, number of zeros, total number of zeros will be 3. And here, because there is one unknown, we will have one variable, and the number of zeros, the number of 1 minus z's will be equal to 2. Very important to understand. So as I told that for DOC 4 we will have to have 3 zeros. So for 3 zeros I told that 2 have to be 1 minus z inverse, and 1 has to be 1 minus bz inverse. Anything like this. So if there are 2 something, so this h0 of z will be equal to 1 minus z inverse whole square times 1 minus vz inverse. Sorry, h0 and h1 also. Okay. This will be the form of this high pass filter. Now, just let me expand this. 1 minus z inverse whole square times 1 minus b z inverse. This square, we'll just try to simplify it. I mean, 1 minus 1, this expansion will lead to 1 minus 2z inverse plus z to the power minus 2. Then when multiplied with 1 minus bz inverse. Like, if you find this multiplication, polynomial multiplication difficult, you can always use the convolution method. 1 minus 2, 1. 1 minus 1. Just multiply all of them. So this is equal to 1. Okay. This is equal to 1 into minus b. Okay. 1 minus 2. 1 minus b. Minus 2b. Sorry, plus 2b. And minus b. The output will be 1 minus 2 minus b then this will be 1 plus 2b and the last will be minus b. So now I got this h1 of z, then this autocorrelation of this h1z with itself, this what will it give? Just take this signal, shift it by this, that I want rxx of 2. So what will I do? Take this signal 1 minus 2 plus b, 1 plus 2b and minus b. I just take this, shift it by, I will try to shift it by 2. And multiply. So this is equal to 1 minus 2 plus b, 1 plus 2b and minus b. And then I multiply both of them. So this I multiply and I add both of them. So what will be the answer? And this has to be equal to 0. Because we conveyed this very clearly. That we only want an impulse as an autocorrelation. No other, all have to be zero. The even positions were already zero. Even positions means this odd number of one, this one and minus one, because this even position means this position, this one, this three. Or the, if the integers, the position, if the integers are even, then we have to make it zero. Just try to understand. So this, if we add the multiplication of this with this, what we get is something like this. 1 plus 2b plus minus 2 plus b times minus b equal to 0. Now if you solve this equation, we will get some value. So the value which we get for b is minus 2 plus minus under root of 3. And out of this value of b, let us take this, which one should we choose? We must choose the value of b in such a way that it lies within the unit circle. So as to satisfy the minimum phase condition. So to satisfy minimum phase condition, because the phase delay should be less as possible, we choose this as this value of b. So once we got the value of b, everything is solved. We get h0, we get h1, we get g0 and we get g1. How we'll get this? This b is equal to minus 2 plus under root of 3. Something, this is what is b. Now we got b, what will we do? We have got h1 of z, so what will be h0 of z? Sorry, first of all, what will be g, this h1, so g1 of z will be equal to h1 of z inverse times z raised to the power, what is the odd, so this log 4 means length 4 means z raised to the power minus 3. In this way, we get g1 So if we have got h1, we have got g1. G0 is equal to h1 of minus z, and g1 is equal to h0 of minus z minus the difference of it. Then this ways we get all the values. So by this we complete what we call the analysis of Dabochi's wavelet. Similarly, it's not necessary that it has to be DOF 4 only. We can have DOF 6 also. In 6 case, just see that we have to have both RxX of 2 equal to 0 and RxX of 4 equal to 0. So in this case, out of all zeros, the number of zeros will be equal to is equal to 5, out of which 2 are unknown. So we will get 1 minus b1 z inverse, 1 minus b2 z inverse. We have two unknowns and we have 3 knowns. So 3 have to be, we told that we have to use as many 1 minus z inverse as we have, as we can, so as to make this smoother and smoother. Why it is smoother, we will explain in a little. But this point has to be clear, that we have to have two unknowns. So these two unknowns will lead to two equations, two unknowns, which will be good enough. And then this the other threes will be 1 minus z inverse only. Once we get this equation, we get h0, h1, g0, g1. So by this we complete what we call the analysis of the Dabochi. But there is just one last concept which I want. Why are we using or maximizing, rather, why are we maximizing 1 minus z inverse? In some sense, 1 minus z inverse is doing nothing but differentiation, difference. Or in other words, if you take x of n as some polynomial, let me take n as 5n raised to the power 4 plus 3n plus 4, 1, anything, okay? Or 3n cubed plus something, 2n. Square plus 1, anything, okay? Let me tell 3 to this. 3n plus 1, okay? If we take something like this, xn, then this, if I apply 1 minus z inverse, or I subtract, I take this xn minus x of n minus 1, if I do. Applying 1 minus z inverse and doing this, will lead me to 5 times n to the power 4 plus 3n plus 1. Minus 5 n to the n minus 1 to the power 4 plus 3 n minus 1 plus 1. So just see, if I expand this, the highest power, if you expand this, this highest power will be gone. So in other words, this 1 minus z inverse is doing nothing but is reducing order of polynomial. Or differentiating. So the more it reduces the order of polynomial, the more it is making it high pass, the more, or we are trying to say that the more it is efficient. So in that case, that is the reason, use as many 1 minus z inverse as possible. So that's the last.